G'day guys, welcome back to the Scooby-Doo Forever channel. Now, firstly, before I get into the episode, I do apologise for not uploading again last week. I did plan to get at least one out, definitely tried to, but couldn't quite get it out in time, so I figured, oh, what's the point on getting it out on a Monday? Might as well wait until the next Saturday. Very sorry about that, but yeah, here it is now. Episode 16, I'll be reviewing it today, of Season 1 of Scooby-Doo and Guess Who, titled 1 Minute Mysteries. So yeah, let's get straight into the review. So yeah, this one was titled, like I said earlier, 1 Minute Mysteries, which guest starred The Flash, the final superhero guest star to appear on Scooby-Doo and Guess Who, being the third of three. And overall, I want to give this episode 5 out of 10. It was pretty poor. The execution of this one was definitely one of the worst of the entire franchise of Scooby-Doo and Guess Who. Yeah, I just didn't like the execution at all. The Flash was alright. He's a great guest star, and he was alright in this one, I thought. But apart from that, there's nothing really else that's good. Of course, it was good to see some of the past creepy villains from Scooby-Doo, Where Are You? You know, like, for a few examples I'll show, like, Captain Cutler and, like, the Creeper. They were really good to see. And yeah, I guess it was alright to see those. Didn't really like how the Flash, because he's super fast, could solve the mysteries in about a minute. And they solved a good 7 or 8 mysteries before they got to the main one, which didn't really last too long and wasn't really the main point of the episode. The main point of the episode, I guess, was that the gang trying to teach the Flash their way of mystery solving during the Creeper one, which went for around 5 to 6 minutes, and then there was about 2 minutes of the big finale, I guess, with evil teddy bear monster kidnapping Daphne, Fred and Velma and basically setting off a whole bunch of explosives in this weird factory, and they'd all blow in 3 seconds, and the Flash would have to try and save everyone in under 3 seconds, and did. So I don't know, it's just such a weird episode. It's pretty popular among fans. I mean, it's either you love it or you dislike it, and I'm a big hater for this one. Yeah, to be honest, I couldn't really find much good things at all. There's a few alright things. I didn't like the teddy bear monster. Obviously gonna like the you know, Scooby-Doo, Where Are You villains, but we barely saw any of them. The main one, obviously, was the Creeper. I liked how they threw a joke in and made the Swamp Witch turn out to be Simone, which was quite funny. Second time now that she's appeared on Scooby-Doo and Guess Who, which was kind of cool to see. And I guess, you know, the Flash's, you know, identity is actually Barry Allen or something, who's, like, a really cool guy, hangs out with Shaggy and Scooby. It's good to see him and Shaggy and Scooby hanging out at, like, the burger place they were always at, you know, eating burgers and just hanging out, having a good time. I believe it was the Big Belly Burger or something like that, the restaurant that they would always eat at. So yeah, to be honest, there's not really that much to say about this episode. I did like how the Flash took every single villain he caught into the Iron Heights jail, which was quite funny. He kept on going back and forth there, capturing every single villain that was, you know, basically set for the gang to solve. And yeah, I don't know, don't really have much of an opinion on this one, just hate mostly everything about it. The Flash was definitely the best thing about this episode, though.
Now let's see who this evil giant teddy bear really is.
The Joker!
That's right, kiddies! I'm here to turn your frowns upside down!
That doesn't make sense! The Joker usually goes after the other guy. You know, tall, dark, broody, pointy ears.
Wait, hold the phone!
The Trickster?
Oh, okay. Now that makes sense.
It's all quite simple, really. From what we learned in the abandoned toy factory, it seems that the Trickster has been watching the Flash, helping us solve our mysteries.
When the Trickster saw that we were friends, he decided to use us against the Flash. He wanted to create a moment where the Flash would have no choice but to expose his secret identity to the world.
It would have been a crowning victory for me. I would have exposed the Flash's real identity to the world. And I would have gotten away with it, too, if it weren't for you meddling kids and famous Justice Leaguer and superhero speedster, the Flash!
Have fun, Trickster.
Hey, Carswell? Always been a big fan of the Creeper costume. Oh, real old-school genius, that one.
Thanks, I guess.
Hope you guys enjoyed the review, a very short one today. Hope you guys enjoyed, and I will see you guys next week.
Gotta keep up, buddy. Falling behind.